Hi, my name is Mario Tibanta from easymetalworking.mottg.com. In this video I want to share with you how to read a vernier caliper in fractions of an inch. Welcome. Reading a caliper in fractions of an inch is simple once the units in which it is divided are mastered and understood. However, we must know that we use inches, and that these are subdivided into smaller expressions and that these subunits are also expressed as a fraction. So, this video is structured in four parts. Part 1, Understanding the Inch. Part 2, Understanding the Subunits of the Inch. Part 3, Understanding the Vernier Scale in Fractions of an Inch. Part 4, Examples of Reading Measurements. An inch is divided into 16 equal parts. If you take a part of these 16 parts you get a fraction, a 16th of an inch. Therefore, 16 parts each of a 16th, joined or added together will result in 16 16ths. Now, if the previous fraction is given a basic operation such as division, that is, if 16 is divided by 16, the result is 1 inch. But, why a division? Because fraction means a division, yes, a division of the numerator versus the denominator, understanding that the numerator is the top half of the fraction and the denominator is the bottom half of the fraction. With these basic concepts of fractionaries we can understand better the management and the reading of fractions of the vernier caliper in inches. As stated earlier, if you take one part of the 16 in which the inch is divided, you get a 16th. If two parts are taken, means that a 16th should be added to a 16th. To add two fractions, you must see their denominators. If denominators are equals, the result of add will be another fractionary with same denominator. In this case, the denominator of the two fractions is 16, then the fractional result will have as denominator 16. Now, we proceed to operate the numerators of the two fractions, so then 1 plus 1 equals 2, so the total value of a 16th plus a 16th equals 2 16th. 2 16th is a number that can be simplified, then, taking halves in numerator we get 1 and again, taking half in denominator we get 8, therefore after simplifying 2 16th an equivalence is obtained, 2 16th is equivalent to an eighth. Warning. All the fractionaries of the vernier caliper in inches must be or be simplified. Now the third fractionary, remember, are 16 main fractionaries that make an inch in the caliper. The third fractionary is, an eighth plus a 16th. To add two fractions, first, we must see the denominators. In this case, the denominators are not the same, therefore the addition cannot be made directly as in the previous case. But this is not a matter of worry. In order not to complicate the exercise, I will work with the concept of fraction amplification. First, you must see the denominators of the two fractions and take the lower value, then the lowest value is 8 which belongs to an eighth and taking advantage of that is an exact divisor of 16, we will multiply it or amplify in such a way that we get instead of a 16 for this, you must multiply an a by 2 in both the numerator and the denominator. 2 times an eighth equals 2 sixteenths, 2 sixteenths is equivalent to 1 eighth. Now you can add the fractions as they have the same denominator. 2 sixteenths plus 1 sixteenth. And it applies again the same process that in the first example, is left the same denominator, number 16 and add the numerators, 2 plus 1 equals 3. So, the value of the third fraction in inches in the vernier caliper is 3 sixteenths. Let's go for the fourth fractional in the caliper. 3 sixteenths plus a sixteenth equals 4 sixteenths, and simplifying is a quarter. Let's go for the fifth fractional in the caliper. A quarter plus a sixteenth equals 5 sixteenths. The sixth fractional is 5 sixteenths plus a sixteenth equals 6 sixteenths, and simplifying is 3 eighths. The seventh fractional is 3/8 plus a 16th equals 7/16. The eighth fractional is 7/16 plus a 16th equals 8/16 equals 4/8 equals 2/4, and simplifying is 1/2. The ninth fractional is 1/2 plus a 16th equals 9/16. The tenth fractional is 9/16 plus a 16th equals 10/16, and simplifying is 5/8. The 11th fractional is 5/8 plus 1/16 equals 11/16. The 12th fractional is 11/16 plus a 16th equals 12/16 equals 6/8, and simplifying is 3/4. The 13th fractional is 3/4 plus a 16th equals 13/16. The 14th fractional is 13/16 plus a 16th equals 14/16, and simplifying is 7/8. The 15th fractional is 7/8 plus a 16th equals 15/16. The 16th fractional is 15/16 plus a 16th equals 16/16 equals 8/8 equals 4/4 equals 2/2 equal 1 inch. As I said at the beginning, an inch is equivalent to 16/16. The vernier scale of the caliper divides a 16th in 8 equal parts. This is 16 divided by 8. In order to divide a fraction by a whole number, we must convert the whole number to fraction. This is doing putting to the whole a denominator, and the value to be always put is the unit or is the number 1. 8 equals 8 divided by 1. Now it is possible to make the division of two fractional numbers. A 16th divide by 8 over 1 and proceed to perform the operation. Turn the second fraction upside down, a 16th times 1 over 8. Now multiply the first fraction by that reciprocally equals 128th. And simplify the fraction if needed. The result is 128th. In the vernier scale of the caliper in inches, the smallest unit you can get is 128 inches. plus 128 equals 228 equals a 64th. A 64th plus 128 equals 328ths. 328ths plus 128th equals 428th equals 264ths, and simplifying is a 32nd. A 32nd plus 128th equals 528ths. 528ths plus 128th equals 628ths, and simplifying is 3/64ths. 3/64ths plus 128th equals 728ths. 728ths plus 128th equals 828ths equals 4/64ths equals 2/32nds equal a 16th. Conclusion: A over 128th is equivalent to a 16th inch. Rules for taking readings from the vernier caliper. 1. Count the graduations in the main scale before the zero of the vernier scale. 2. Verify the graduation of the vernier scale that matches exactly a graduation of the main scale in inches. 3. If the first or the third or the fifth or the seventh gradation of the vernier scale matches with one graduation of the main scale, then the number of graduations of the main scale that are before the zero of the vernier scale by 8 is multiplied. If the first graduation of the vernier scale matches with one graduation of the main scale is added 1. If the third graduation of the vernier scale matches with one graduation of the main scale is added 3. If the fifth graduation of the vernier scale matches with one graduation of the main scale, is added 5, and if the seventh graduation of the vernier scale matches with one graduation of the main scale, is added 7. The previous value is the fractional numerator, the denominator is 128. 4. If the second or the sixth graduation of the vernier scale coincides with one of the main scale, then the number of graduations of the main scale that are before the zero of the vernier scale by 4 is multiplied. If the second graduation of the vernier scale matches with one of the main scale, is added 1, and if the sixth graduation of the vernier scale matches with one of the main scale, is added 3. The previous value is the fractional numerator, the denominator is 64. 5. If the fourth graduation of the vernier scale matches with one graduation of the main scale, then the number of graduations of the main scale that are before the zero of the vernier scale by 2 is multiplied and added 1. The previous value is the fractional numerator, the denominator is 32. If in the fractional reading of the vernier caliper an inch is the zero of the vernier scale passes from the number 1 of the main scale, means that an inch has been exceeded, therefore to the reading in fractions must be added the value indicated in the main scale before the fractional. Examples of reading measurements: 3 quarters inch, 5 64ths inches, 19 128ths inches, 25 32nds inches, 11 128ths inches, 3 16ths inches, 1528 inches, 127/128 inches, 2.5 inches. I hope this information is useful and helpful to you. Now I want to ask you the following. First, go to www.ecmetalworking.mot.com for more help and information on everything related to machinism and machinist. Second, remember to subscribe to my channel. So that every time I post a new video, with more valuable information, I can let you know. Third, click on like and put your comment or question, it will be a pleasure to answer you. And finally, share this video on your favorite social media and let all your friends know about it, someone might need it. I hope that everything you saw today will be useful to you. Was with you, Mario Tybunt from www.ecmetalworking.mot.com. Thanks for watching.